Welcome to this week's episode of the DevOps Lab. With us this week, we have Will Tai from the Dapper Incubations team, who's going to talk us through Dapper and Azure Container Apps. So tune in, watch the show, and we look forward to seeing you. Welcome to this week's episode of the DevOps Lab. And with us this week, we have a very special guest, Will Tai. Welcome, Will.
Hi, April. Thanks for having me.
Really excited to have you here. You're part of the Dapper team, aren't you?
I am, yes. I'm specifically on the Azure Incubations team. I'm a PM, and Dapper has been one of the projects that I've been working on.
Awesome. So we've had your colleagues on the show telling us what is Dapper. We talked about Dapper on AKS. Today, we're going to talk about deploying Dapper onto Azure Container Apps. So Will, take it away.
Yeah, definitely. Paul and Nick did a great job showing Dapper and talking a little bit more about how Dapper works. And like you said, I'm here to talk to you about Container Apps today, which is currently available in private preview. And I'm very excited to show you some of the functionality that it has and the integrations with Dapper. But maybe I'll give you a quick overview of what Container Apps actually is before we dive in.
That'd be awesome, because they're brand new, aren't they?
Yeah. Just really brand new, released about a month ago. Container Apps is a managed service, which offers a platform for you to run microservices in containers with built-in capabilities for things like auto-scaling, application upgrades, traffic shifting, and versioning. And best of all, it offers a fully managed version of Dapper APIs for you to build your microservices. So you can enable your Dapper sidecars to run next to your microservices, and then you can leverage all the capabilities of Dapper and all the functionality that Dapper provides, all without needing to manage and maintain your own Dapper or Kubernetes infrastructure. So that's all the benefits of containers and Dapper without the pain of maintenance. Isn't that great?
That's awesome. I mean, I think the big leap for customers going to AKS was the overhead maintenance, and developers struggled with kind of like the networking components and the infrastructure components. And then you had infrastructure specialists struggling with like the rest of AKS, right? So this is awesome. See Container Apps available in preview now. I believe it's private preview, public preview. I'm so excited to see how Dapper integrates into that, because it's such a cool service in Azure.
Yeah, definitely. And we can take a look at my screen and I can show you exactly, what it looks like in action. I have a demo set up ready for us to walk through.
Cool.
Awesome. So the demo that I'm going to walk through today is actually available in the Azure Samples repo. It's this Container App Store API microservices demo. And I'll run you through real quick what we're actually going to do here. So this is the architecture diagram. We're going to deploy three container apps. So we have the Store API, Order Service, and Inventory Service. These are three distinct container apps. That each have Dapper enabled. So each will have a Dapper sidecar running alongside it to help the apps do service invocation and also help this order service do state stores. And then maybe I'll walk you through a little bit what each application does so that we can follow along as we proceed through the demo. Mm-hmm. So we have the Store API. So think about this as like an online shop or even a physical shop, and these services support this shop. So you have the Store API that's got some APIs and a UI built into this Node.js app, fronted by Azure API Management to expose the API for clients. And when you interact with the Store API, you create orders, and the orders will go into the order service, whose job is to retrieve and store orders into the state store, which is configured to use Cosmos DB. And then there's also an inventory service that your Store API interacts with. And the inventory service in practice should be the service that checks inventory and returns the status of your inventory. But in our case, it's a simple application. So just for the purposes of demonstration, the inventory service just returns some static responses.
Cool.
All right. Well, this particular demo is actually really nicely set up in terms of deployment. The recommended mm-hmm. deployment here is using the GitHub Actions that's been pre-configured. So real easy, you set up a couple of environment variables and secrets, and mm-hmm. then you run the workflow and everything like this entire demo and all the apps deploy for you. So I've already done that. And once you do the deployment here, you will get the setup like this. And basically, it's that architecture diagram that I showed all deployed into your resource group. So now we're ready to actually interact with the app. So in Node app here, if you click on it, there will be you'll be able to find the public URL for it, which is the ingress URL, which is this one here, this Node app dot nice mushroom URL. And we can now interact with the app that we just deployed. So let's pretend we're running a grocery store here. How about that?
Okay.
So we'll give it an order ID of 1. And let's say the first item we'll order is bread. So we'll create the order. And we'll get this confirmation screen that the bread order was created. And this is the sort of the data payload that gets saved into the Cosmos DB table. And then now we can actually view an order by the order ID number, order ID number 1. So if you view it, you'll see that it's retrieving it from the Cosmos DB state store, the order that we just created.
Okay.
And then inventory status, like I said, it returns just a static result. So no matter what you put in here, it'll tell you it's in stock. So we don't restore without inventory problems here.
Good. That is a rarity these days. So we can get bread. That's cool.
Exactly. So we'll add one more just to you know, show you that these orders are being created and it's not pre-canned. So putting an order 2, and just to show you that you know, these are real orders that are being processed. If I put order number 3. Notice that we haven't created order number 3, so it should return an order not available. Message. Yep. Order with that ID found. All right. So what's just a quick recap, what it's doing, what we've been doing is interacting with the store API, which is then in turn interacting with these two services, right? So we've been storing orders and we've also been querying the inventory service. So let's go back here and take a look at the orders that are and confirm that the orders are actually being stored. So we can look at our Cosmos DB instance. We can use the Data Explorer and look into the database, look into our instance and our table. And you will see over here that we have order ID number 1, which should be bread, confirmed. Order ID number 2, which should be milk, also confirmed. So this confirms that this leg of the traffic is being on it, so it's being stored. And then we can look at next is application insights. So we'll just do the last 30 minutes, do a quick refresh, and you'll see, so this is another feature of container apps that is just absolute killer. It's application insights. We, as a part of our deployment in the deployment script, we deployed an application insights resource. And the integration that Container Apps has is with Application Insights and, more importantly, with Dapper. Dapper emits metrics that can then be captured in Application Insights to show you the telemetry of your applications. And what my favorite here is the application map. So it basically shows you all the applications that you have live and running and the traffic that's been made to it. So if you recall, we made a couple of calls to Python app to create and query orders. So you'll see these 5 calls. And we made one call to Go app to just quick test the query of bread to see the inventory levels. So this is really awesome. And all comes basically like without any incremental work if you deploy container apps with Dapper enabled.
And that's awesome because that gives you and the team and everyone else full visibility of end-to-end, you know, exactly what your order process is, what the time is, if there's any latency, and it shows that all our instances went through. So we have full kind of traceability from end-to-end. That's awesome.
Exactly. Yeah, but, you know, the goodness of Dapper doesn't just stop there, right? Like Paul and Nick talked about the portability of Dapper and how you mm-hmm. can basically make changes to your applications without changing the application code. So let's test that. You'll notice that in my resource group here, I actually have an extra resource here, the storage account. This actually wasn't provisioned with the original deployment. I went back in and deployed an additional storage account here because I want to illustrate the portability here. So what we're going to do is over here, we're going to swap out the state store. Right now it's configured to Cosmos DB and that's the original deployment. We're going to switch it to the blob storage account that I just created. Okay. So let's do that here. So recall that the Python app is the one that's responsible for storing state. So we can go into our resources. We can click into the Python app, which I have already opened up here. And within Python app, within the Python container app, you can go into this revision management tab. So a revision is basically a version of the app that you can create. And what's really cool about these revisions is you can basically split the traffic between two revisions. So if you create a new revision, you can say like 50% of the traffic goes to the new app, 50% stays on the old app. And it's a good way to split traffic to do things like A/B testing or even to do incremental migrations if you're cutting over to a new version of an app.
That's awesome. That's really, really cool because so many customers look to deploy something and want that ability to run tests and slowly but continuously roll out their changes, but not always throw it to their production application. That's awesome.
Exactly. So we're going to create a new revision because we want to change the app and specifically change which state store it's going to store state into. So let's do this and create a new revision here. And in this, everything will keep the same. We'll base it on the previous revision, which is this IY2K0K7 revision. Mm-hmm. And we'll keep everything else the same. We'll keep our scaling rules the same. So I have it set at scale up to 10 replicas and then scale down to no more than one. And then this is where we need to make some changes. So this is the Dapper blade. And basically, we'll keep everything else the same, except for this Dapper component that we have. Right now, it's configured to Azure Cosmos DB. What we're going to do is delete this particular component and then add a new one. So we're going to call it orders. Sorry if I can spell here.
It's okay. Another day ending in Y. I can never spell my own name right. I completely understand, Will.
Yes. And then, of course, the emoji screen popped up. I didn't want to name it an emoji. That would be unprofessional. And then and then we have component type, which mm-hmm. I will use state.azure.blobstorage. And then version will say V1. And you might be wondering, how do I know all this? Well, I'm referencing these fields in the Dapper component schema. And that's available in the Dapper documentation. So V1, state.azure.blobstorage, right? And you'll notice we have metadata. So we have these three metadata fields that we also then need to configure in the UI, account name, account key, and container name. So we'll go back and do that. So we just add a metadata field called account name. And then we'll do a manual entry. And the account name is actually the name of the blob storage account that I had provisioned earlier. So it's just this over here. And recall, it's this the same as this account name over here. So we'll do that. We'll add it in. And then we'll add one more metadata field called account key. Mm-hmm. And account key, I actually added it as a secret into Python app in Azure already. So we'll just reference that secret account key.
Cool. And it keeps it a secret in that screen as well. So it's not visible.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And,
cool.
And it's best practice to manage secrets this way.
Absolutely.
And then we will add another one called container name, right? So this will be container name. And we'll do manual entry. We'll call it just orders. Mm-hmm. All right. So we'll add. And then once everything looks good, you have the new component added, we'll click create. And this will take a few minutes to deploy the new revision.
Okay, cool. But we'll have two copies of our revision. So we'll have the original app that was going to Cosmos, and then we'll have the new one going to storage. And then we can divide up the traffic, split the traffic, do some A/B testing, or even almost like a canary deployment if we wanted to as well.
Exactly, exactly. So once it's deployed, it will show up on the screen, and we'll be able to make those any adjustments we need and proceed. So it looks like the deployment succeeded. We got this success message. So we'll hit refresh, and we should see the new revision up. So this was our previous revision, this IY one, and now we have this FLT one that we just created. So for the purposes of our demonstration, I'm not going to split the traffic because we want to guarantee to show you that we can move the traffic from the state store, storing state in Cosmos to Blob, right? So what I'm going to do is bring the previous revision down to zero and add 100% for the traffic to go to the new revision. And I'll also deactivate the old revision. So what's going to happen here is we're going to do another save, and it will do another sort of update and deployment, which will then confirm the settings we just saved here. All right, so it looks like our revision just got updated as well. So we'll give it a quick refresh to confirm that 100% of the traffic is on our newest revision, and that's the active one. Great, so now we're ready to see this in action. We'll go back to our UI, and let's just give it a quick refresh. All right, so in this new UI, recall that we added ID number 2 last, and that should be, this is actually good because order ID not found, because we're now looking for order number 2 in the blob storage, which you just switched to. And of course, we haven't stored anything to the blob storage. So we'll let's store something in there first. So let's do order ID number 3, and this time let's buy some eggs.
Cool.
All right, so order created, and we should see eggs in the state store when we query it. And then of course, we'll just for posterity, we'll look at inventory status and confirm that it's returning the static response of that it's in stock.
Awesome.
All right.
So we have eggs, bread, and milk.
Exactly. Eggs, bread, and milk. But if everything worked, bread and milk should be in Cosmos DB. Eggs should be in blob storage. So let's confirm that. So we'll go into our blob storage. We'll go into our storage browser. We'll go into blob containers. And the container we had created was orders. So you'll see order number 3, which is eggs, is has been stored into our blob storage over here. And then I'll show you that our Cosmos DB items should not have changed. So we still have order ID number 1, which was bread, and order ID number 2, which is milk. So there we have it. We switched out the state store. All without touching a single line of the source code. It was all just configuration change and a redeployment of the app, and we're able to switch it out. And that right there is the portability that Dapper offers you in your application development.
That's awesome, Will. Thank you so much. And it's great to see that we can go in and change that configuration and the data doesn't disappear. We don't have to touch the data. We don't have to touch the source code, but we can slot in those resources and change those about if we need to.
Exactly. Yep. That's exactly what we demonstrated today in a very simple but practical app.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much for joining. It's been awesome having you on the show and learning about Dapper on Azure Container Apps. So thank you everyone for joining. It's been an awesome series on Dapper, and we'll put the links for that Will used in the show for you to review after. So thank you all, and tune in next time to the DevOps Lab.